Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for joining. This is a Sony product, Bose Solo.
Showtime.
This compact soundbar. Place the speaker in front of your TV on the wall. Simple setup, installation, simple to do. Only one connection to your TV. Advanced audio technology creates clear, natural sound, dialogue at all levels. Bluetooth connectivity. Stream music wirelessly. Includes remote control. Simplified remote for easy operation. Includes wall mount. Mount the speaker to the wall with the easy to install bracket. Dialogue mode makes every world even easier to hear. Let's open up the product, see what it has for you to store. It sells for $200 plus, has a $20 discount, can be found at your local price club or any retail store. The instruction manual. It comes in many different languages. Please read it because it has some important information provided. If you want to use the remote control, you're going to have to contact your cable TV provider to make this work with a remote control. And it must be a universal remote control. This will not work with Bluestream, TiVo remote control. So you can use the supplied cables that they give you, the sound optical cable hooked up to your TV. We're going to simply hook it up to your smartphone and hopefully play something that is not infringed or copyrighted to YouTube. Taking the product out is neatly wrapped. Is pretty well protected. They tell you which is the left and which is the right. It is marked on the cardboard. You need to have power to run this unit. It is not battery operated. So looking at the back, this is where the wall mount will go. It simply screws in, attaches to the wall. This is your HDMI port, RCA cable, sound optical cable, power area. And you have a optional option plug. This is a subwoofer baffle area. It is made of nice plastic and it's got a nice front grill. So it is a very interesting product. Located in this particular area are going to be some of the parts that you need to run the product. Hooking up to your TV, you got your optical cable, you got your power supply, you got your cord that attaches to it, it's a good length, and you got the remote control. Do apologize that it slipped, and it's simply workable. IR, you need to point it to the product, you got to be pretty close to it. So if I press it on, you can see the infrared light lighting up from the camera, and you got the wall mount right here. So this is everything that's in the box. Now, I'm going to show you how to hook it up to power. You find an outlet. Be careful of the ends. You don't want to get electrocuted if there are any contacts exposed. Simply line it up, square to circle. And we are all hooked up. You have a standby. And the standby light will be amber versus the red. You may or may not see it. It's right over here with my index finger. It's on standby. So how hard is this to hook up? Well, we hit our settings of the iOS Apple iPhone 6 device, we look for Bluetooth. We allow the other device to connect. I'm sorry if the screen is washed out or too far away. We hit the Bluetooth device on the remote control. It says miscellaneous, M-I-S-C, at the bottom of the remote control. We should be hooked up. We simply go to Pandora, and this should play. Raise the music up. Now, I hope these videos were to your liking. Showing you the product, how it was working. It is an excellent product for your TV, and if you want to listen to music on the go, on the side, it's not as compact as your Bluetooth, not meant to be that particular way. So I hope this review of the product is to your liking, for what we need it to be used for, in conjunction to another remote control, bypassing this remote control. It doesn't use one remote control for us. And that's one of the reasons why we don't like it. We found out that our TV set, raising up certain sound areas, optimizing the TV sound, creates almost the same sound as this particular product. So it's all up to you if it's worth getting a soundbar for your setup. So on that note, I want to thank you for stopping by, checking out this review. Just make sure when you purchase a product that you don't damage it, so you can return it and just say, hey, I give it a shot. It wasn't worth what I expected it to be. The Sony soundbar. You decide if it's for you. $200 and some odd, it's a well worth product to look at. Just not for us. We wanted it to be compact so it could be traveling to and from locations. Hook it up very easy. And it is. It's just not ready for us to have one of these at this given time. So on that note, would I go out and get one? Yes, I would definitely go out and purchase one. It's a well worth product. So, I thank you very much for stopping by, checking out this review. Have a great day. And have a good one.